All right. I know. The title of this episode was a little clickbaity, but I think it's an important message for today's daily detail tip. And that is, you know, if I were to, by the way, I love everyone that messages me, that reaches out, that I hear your story, that I hear where you're at in your journey with detailing, that I hear all that. I love it. Whether you're, you know, been in it 30 years, you got a freaking shop that's just busting ass, or you've been in it a year and you got a shop that's busting ass, or you got 15 trucks out on the road or 4 trucks out on the road, all the way down to you guys that are found this podcast, have just found me, and you're in your first 6 months of detailing and you're still doing it on the side or whatever. From the whole gamut, I love hearing your guys' story, and I'm really a sucker for stories, so I don't know if anyone out there is the same, but I'm really a sucker for stories more than anything. Anyway, so today's daily detail tip stems from the stories that I hear when people just like you and I write in. And if this were to happen, you know, once or twice, I probably wouldn't talk about it, or maybe it would, you know, segue into something else. But I get this, I wouldn't say all the time, but very often. And very often the scenario is, Jimbo, I've been detailing 3 years, 1 year, 6 months, 5 years. Or, Jimbo, I've been trying to get this detailing thing off the ground for 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, whatever, and I can't get it to pop. What am I doing wrong? How do I get more customers? How, blah, 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 blah. And of course, I would be, this is not, let me preface this, this is not the reason for this. It just popped in my brain, and a lot of times I just start talking, and whatever pops in my brain is what I end up talking about. But this is not a plug for the Detailer Inner Circle. But if you are having a problem getting customers, the Detailer Inner Circle will completely change that and eradicate your issue with needing to find customers. But here's, again, not a plug for that. But people or guys that reach out that need to find new customers or need to find customers at all, want to go full-time, what I notice they're doing is they're looking at guys that have been in the industry for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, whatever, and have a super established business, that have really worked hard, killed it, beat the pavement, and done all that. And they're looking at those guys and going, I want to be like that. But what they don't realize is that, so they're looking at what those guys are doing. Maybe they're doing a lot of coatings. Maybe they're only doing correction and coatings. There's some guys like that. But two things that I want to touch on for that is they weren't there when those guys started. You know, I know, I'll just speak from my experience. When I started, I was doing cheap car washes. There was one thing that was hot for whatever reason in my area when I first got started, and it was swirl mark removal. So literally buffer trails that were being left by body shops, and for whatever reason at that time in 2008, 2009, no one in my local area could remove machine-induced swirl marks. So I simply couldn't afford a rotary polisher. All I could afford was a Porter Cable 7424, which, by the way, I got for Christmas from my family because I couldn't afford it because my business wasn't making any money yet. And so I took that Porter Cable with a random, probably thrash pad and some literally swirl mark removal polish, and I made money doing that. Right? Was I doing a full paint correction? No. But was I, here's the golden ticket, hitting the needs and wants of the customer? Yes. And that's where I see a lot of guys get kind of jumbled up and twisted up, is that they're listening to other detailers on these Facebook groups and forums, and what they're not doing is paying attention to their customers' wants, needs, and desires. They listen to a detailer on a Facebook group and a forum say, you can't clay a car without polishing after, right? Which, is that true? Probably. But here's the reality of it. Can a customer notice the difference if you polish a car or don't polish a car after you clay it? Or does that lady or that guy whip out their wallet and freaking write a check on the hood of his car after you've done it, right? So I'm not saying that you shouldn't polish after you clay. I'm saying you should really know the needs and wants and desires of your customer. And you need to know that. So yes, paint correction is stupid and you should stop doing it if that's not the needs of the customer. If you have a really picky customer and they start talking about things like micro marring and they're really a prosumer, so there's this whole niche of customers coming out, and I think it's going to be even more in the future, so I think we need to start gearing and talking a little bit more towards that, especially when it does come to correction and coatings. But there's a whole new arena, new section of customers that I'm qualifying as prosumers. They could do it. They could detail their own car. They read all the forums, all the Facebook groups. They know all the right lingo, but they're a consumer. They don't do it for a business. So I'm starting to see some of these people kind of come into my circle as customers, and maybe thinking about it off the top of my head, I should dedicate a little bit more time to how to handle those people. But the overarching way to handle all these people and really nail down what your customer really wants is to ask a ton of questions. That is the golden ticket. And a lot of these guys, a lot of you guys that reach out and talk about how do I get more customers and blah, blah, blah. One, free work is still the number one marketing play ever, doing free work. And I know a lot of guys, you know, bitch and moan about that, but it's not free work forever. Excuse me. It's free work to get your name out there. And by the way, it doesn't have to be free. It could be, let me wash your car for $20. And guess what? I'll wax it for free. And by waxing it, you may be doing a spray wax, right? It's not going to be a machine polish. It's, you have to make it work for you. But the goal is that when you're just starting your business, no one knows who you are. And no one knows that you're different. No one knows that your customer service is different. No one knows that you actually show up when you make an appointment. No one knows that you do great work. No one knows you. And so you have to build up that level of not only people knowing you, but also trust within your local community, within your local circle, within your local influence around you. So you have to be aware of all those things, but ask a lot of questions. So when someone says, I need a full detail, you know, and a lot of guys, I see a lot of guys bitch and moan about, well, they wanted a full detail and I quoted them $500 and they just pissed and moaned about it being too expensive and, you know, go hire a cheap detailer and then you'll really know how expensive I am, you know, and it's like, well, wait, if you asked a few more leading questions. So what I like to say is, you know, customer calls, oh, I want a perfect example. Guy has a boat, called me yesterday. I need my boat detailed. I'm like, okay, what does that mean to you? He's like, well, you know, and then his first remark is like, what an idiot, right? Like, who did I call? Like, what do you mean? I want it fully detailed. And I'm like, yeah, I get that. But what does a full detail mean to you? Do you need the carpets shampooed? Do you need the vinyl cleaned and conditioned? Do you need it machine polished? Oh, no. It's just, you know, and this is the guy coming back. No. It's just a little dusty. It's really dusty more than anything. And in fact, you did it last year and you machine polished it last year and did a really deep detail last year, so I don't need that again. It's like, oh, okay. And then I'm thinking in my head, okay, well, before I quoted him at $500 or $1,000 and let him walk down the road, I asked a few following questions to figure out what a full detail means to him. Because a full detail to him and a full detail to me are probably two completely different things. So I guess the quick tip would be to ask more questions. Do you need the carpet shampooed or do you just need a really thorough vacuum? Do you need the exterior? Does the paint feel rough? Does it not feel rough? Would you like to send me some pictures? Here's the best one. What bothers you the most? When you sit in your car, when you look at your car, when you walk to your car in the parking lot from coming inside the grocery store, what bothers you the most about your car that you want fixed? And if you nail those things, you'll have a customer for life. But if you go in with your own agenda, unless they ask for it, it's not a very good play, in my opinion. So I know this quick tip went a little long, looking at almost 10 minutes, but ask a lot of questions. Don't do paint corrections if the customer's not asking for it or if you can't convince them in it. Test spots are great, free test spots, free services or discounted services to get your name out there. Being mobile obviously helps because you can pound the pavement, go into office buildings, cut your teeth, get your name out there. No one knows about you, and unfortunately, no one cares about you. No one cares about me. That's why you got to pound the pavement and show people why they should care about you. So hopefully you get something out of that and it's not just a 10-minute ramble. Of course, feedback is always appreciated, whether it's positive or negative. I really want to steer this ship in the right direction to help as many of you guys out there as possible, and gals. So let me know what you thought. All right, catch you on the next one. See ya.